I am Dr. Annasuro Vijayendran, Dean Computing, Department of Computer Science, Sri Ramakrishna College of Arts and Science, Coimbatore. Today, we are going to see about the virtual memory. Virtual memory is nothing but separation of user logical memory from physical memory. Only a part of the program needs to be in the memory for execution. Logical address space can therefore be much larger than the physical address space. Allows address spaces to be shared by several processes. It allows more efficient process creation. More programs can run concurrently. Less I/O is needed to load or swap process. Virtual memory can be implemented via demand. So this is the structure for the virtual memory. This is, you have got the virtual memory, the memory map, the physical memory, and the backing store. So if all the pages will be stored in the backing store, from the backing store, the pages will be moved on to the physical memory for further. Next is demand paging. What is demand paging? It can bring entire process into the memory at the load time, or bring a page into memory only when it is needed. The advantages of demand paging is less I/O is needed, no unnecessary I/O is used, less memory is needed, faster response, more uses. If page needed and are not in memory, need to detect and load the page in the memory from the storage. Page is needed, then you have to reference to it. If it is an invalid reference, you abort that. If it is not in the memory, bring it to the memory. Lazy swapper never swaps a page into memory unless the page is needed. The swapper that deals with the pages is known as the pager. So in the page table, we have got two types of bits, namely valid and invalid bit. With each page table entry, a valid and invalid bit is associated. If the bit is set as V, that means the page is in the memory. If it's set as I, that means the page is not in the memory. Initially, the valid and the invalid bit are set to I for all entries. If there is a reference to a particular page, and if the page is not available in the memory, then a trap will be sent to the operating system. That is what is known as the page fault. So how to handle the page fault? Here we have given the diagram. That is, you are in the memory, you have got one instruction known as load yum. So the load yum, that particular page should be available in the primary memory. Okay, so we are searching that particular thing in the page table. So in the page table, it has been, the particular page has been set as I. That means the page is not available in the memory. So immediately we are giving a trap to the operating system. The operating system in turn search that particular page, the backing store. If it finds that page onto the backing store, immediately it will search for a free frame in the primary memory, in the physical memory, and it will load that page onto the free frame. Then it will reset the page table. That is, the I will be changed to V, and the instruction will be restarted and the process will be continuing. This is how the page faults will be handled. So what is page fault? If a particular page is not available in the memory, and if the particular page is needed for further execution, immediately we are giving a trap to the operating system stating that that particular page is not available. That is what is known as the page fault. Page replacement. So, you are trapping the information you are giving the information to the operating system, that is a page fault has been trapped. The operating system is searching for that particular page in the backing store. If the page is available in the backing store, it is searching for a free frame and it is putting that page onto the free frame. Supposing if the frames are all full, that is there is no empty frame, in that case what to do? So in that particular situation, page replacement comes into existence. The page replacement occurs when a page fault occurs and we need to bring the desired page into the memory, but there are no free frames. Page replacement find some page in the memory but not really in use and page it out. So what page replacement is doing? It is searching the physical memory and it is finding out a page that is not really in use, the pages that is kept idle. It is finding out that particular page and immediately it is moving that particular page to the backing store and giving the room to the new page that is needed for further execution. And we have got different types of algorithms. That algorithms will decide which frame to free, and the performance of this algorithm can be found out by getting the minimum number of page fault. Whichever algorithm results in minimum page fault, that performance, that algorithm's performance will be treated as good. The same page may be brought into memory several times. All the frames are used, no free frames. User 2 needs the B. So B is here. So we are finding out the thing and we are moving out one of the pages and then we are loading that particular that. So the basis of the page replacement is, first it should find a location in the desired page on the disk. Second one, find a free frame. That is, when a trap has occurred, immediately the operating system is searching that particular page on the backing store. That is the first step. Next one, is searching for a free frame. If there is a free frame, immediately it will be using it. If there is no free frame, it is using a page replacement algorithm. This page replacement algorithm, what it will do, it will select the victim frame and write the victim frame onto the disk if dirty. That means that particular page is not used for a long period. It is idle. That's why we are telling it is dirty. Bring the desired page into the newly free frame. So whichever place we are freed, in that particular position, we are bringing in the desired page. Then update the page and the frame table. That means everything will be set as V, valid. Continue the process by restarting the instruction that caused the. So this is how the page replacement will occur. This is the diagram page replacement algorithm. You are going to see about the three main page replacement algorithm. The first one is first in, first out algorithm. Second one is the optimal algorithm. And the third one is least recently used algorithm. Now we'll see about the first in, first out algorithm, that is FIFO algorithm. Here we have taken a reference string. So this reference string means that these are the numbers of the page. So from these pages are used in our program. So 7 is one page, 0 is another page, 1 is another page, that many strings you have given. And we are using three frames. That means the physical memory, we have got three frames. We have divided the whole physical memory into three frames. And in the initial stage, all the frames are free. First, we are loading the 7th page. Next, we are loading the 0th page. Then we are loading the first page. So after loading these three, your physical memory is full. Next page reference is 2. There is no space for 2. So immediately what happens, you are giving a trap. So your operating system will check for a free frame. So which according to the first in first out algorithm, whichever page comes in first, that has to be removed. So here which comes first? 7 comes first. So we are moving 7 to the backing store and 2 will be replaced on that free frame. Next one, we got 0. That 0 is here, so nothing, no page fault. Again, you have got 3. That 3 is not available here, so we want to put that 3. So which one we have to remove? We have to remove the page which comes first. So here, after 7, 0 has come. So you are removing that 0 and you are putting this 3. Next one is 1, that is available. So next what happens? We are searching for 0. The next one is 0. For 0, there is no space. So immediately what you have to do? You have to find out which page comes first. In that case, the 1 has come earlier. So 1 will be removed and 0 will be pasted. Likewise, we have to make changes. And finally, total number of faults we are getting is 15 page faults. So this algorithm works better and it is easy to implement, but the only disadvantage is there are more page faults. Why there are more page faults means when a page comes in, immediately you are moving it out to the backing store. For example, that 0 has comes in, immediately you are telling that 0 is already available, so you are removing it. Again, after 2 seconds, it is coming in. Likewise, the page is coming in and going out, so the page fault is occurring. In order to avoid that, what happens? We are going for use. So counter is time of use implementation. That means every page table entry has a counter associated with it. Every time a page is referenced to this entry, the content of the clock is copied into the counter. We replace the page with the smallest time value, search through the table. In case of stack implementation, keep a stack of page numbers in a doubly linked form. Page is referred, move it to the top, requires 6 pointers to be changed. No search for replacement. LRU needs special hardware and still it is slow. So LRU, that is the least recently used, and the OPT, that is optimal algorithm, are the cases of stack algorithms, and that they don't suffer from Belardis anomaly. So this Belardis anomaly, they are LRU and optimal doesn't suffer from this Belardis anomaly, but first come first out algorithm suffers from Belardis anomaly. So what is Belardis anomaly? That means when the number of frames increases, the page fault also increases. Normal cases, when the page frames are more, the page fault will be less. That is a normal condition. Belardis anomaly is when the page frames are more, the page fault is also more. This condition will occur only in the case of first come first served algorithm and not in the case of LRU and